I think that when this comes down to, when you talk about people saying that Trump is bad for democracy,
sure,
the issue becomes is that Donald Trump has told us that from day one, he plans what he plans on doing. We know what he plans on doing. And it's also, let's not forget, on January 6th, he encouraged his supporters to storm the Capitol to try to overend the election results and upend democracy. That is not forgotten. And an insurrection on American soil is absolutely abhorrent to everything this country stands for. And that was a huge national security problem beyond the fact that they were trying to hang the vice president and come after Nancy Pelosi and every other member of Congress that they didn't agree with. That's a problem. And we can't allow somebody who did that once, told us what he's going to do to make sure to evangelicals when he reminded them, if you vote for me this time, you are not going to have to vote again. We know he wants to be a dictator on day one. There's no question about that. And when we're looking at this election and when we're thinking about a Trump presidency take two, that's a non-starter for me. And I refuse to support that. Conversely, in the same vein, let me be very clear. That doesn't mean that I think that what the Democrats are doing are completely is like all roses and sunshine, because that's not true either. Both parties are at fault and both parties have a lot of cleaning up to do. But when it comes November 5th, I can assure you that I'm not voting Donald Trump.
Well, I wrote a column calling it an insurrection. I was very tough on that. However, there's been some interesting developments since then. And one of those is that the Supreme Court ruled that it wasn't obstruction of justice. That's pretty interesting. And it was a joint ruling with Democrats and Republicans. Jackson joined the Republicans in that ruling. So the idea that it was insurrection is not true. It wasn't an insurrection. The Supreme Court ruled it was not obstruction. Now, right now, what they're doing is they're going after everybody for other things like trespassing and destruction of property and things like that. And don't get me wrong, people should be in trouble for what happened, and I'm disgusted by it. And it's the primary reason I won't support him, of a couple reasons, including immigration. But I thought that was horrible. However, you're talking 4 years ago, this idea that Trump is going to come in and be a dictator when he's already president one time. If he is a dictator, like I like to say, he's probably one of the most ineffective dictators we've ever seen, because he did leave office. He was convicted of 34 felonies. He didn't even complete the wall that he said he was going to build. He's not that effective. And in a country like ours, which is decentralized like it is across county and state and federal lines, it's extraordinarily difficult for some person to just come in willy-nilly, take over the country. You don't think that people are going to push back even in his own government? You actually believe he's going to come in here and become a dictator? Because I don't even think Biden believes that. Biden was putting on a Trump hat just 2 weeks ago and doing a photo op. Somebody who really thinks that Trump is going to come in and be a dictator doesn't put on a Make America Great Again hat and do a photo op. If this were Hitler and that hat had a swastika and you really believe this guy's going to come in here and take it, can you imagine someone putting on a swastika hat and be like, haha, I'm going to take a photo? Of course not. So I don't think Democrats really believe this. I think it's great for politics. And I think that that's why they're relying on it so much, because it's going to win over a lot of people. But is it true? I don't think it's true. I don't buy it. And I don't think anything suggests that it's going to happen.
Look, that's a risk I'm not willing to take, just to be quite honest. It is, honestly, there are days where I think back to the election of 2020, and it is borderline a miracle the man left the office. And that is not lost on me. I know what his supporters, specifically the extremists, the Proud Boys, Oath Keepers, 3%ers, et cetera, what they are capable of. And I know what their mission is. And it is literally, we are very fortunate that he left office and that we did have a transfer of power. And I don't know if we would be that lucky again. And that's a risk I'm not going to take.
Well, I don't blame you for that. And I'm not trying to sell anybody on voting for Trump, right? That's a hard thing to say, hey, go ahead and vote for him. I have other reasons why I'm not going to vote for Trump. I don't like the act to begin with, but I'm not sold that he's going to come in here and be a dictator. And in fact, the Government Accountability Office released that transcript showing that he had requested a police presence, troops, the National Guard, to be there that day and was denied. And so I think that undermines a lot of the new case and the previous case against him. I think there's other circumstantial evidence. But I'm not sure it's going to go all the way. And I don't know how much this information even gets out to the normal public, but I'm sure.
Well, yeah, I would agree. And from what I understand about that case, it actually won't even be heard or tried until 2026.
Right.
So, because it has to go, to my understanding, and again, I'm not a lawyer, it has to go through the Supreme Court, will hear it. And it's like a whole thing. So it's going to take a while before this even happens. So it's interesting because I don't know if you've seen this, but I've seen people talking about the paperwork that was released yesterday and, you know, like, oh my gosh, this is the October surprise. And I'm like, guys, no, like it's not, it's damning. Yes. But is this the surprise? No, like every presidential election has like the October surprise. I'm like, this is not it. And the runway on this is so long. People will forget about it within a week. And next thing you know, it'll pop back up in 2026 when it does hit the docket.